One of the challenges for Indian beekeepers is remembering which hives need help and then tracking progress over time. We'll look at why this is important, what has been done in the past, and a couple of ideas that I explored. So why is tracking hive progress important? But when commercial beekeepers start to have a lot of hives, remembering the details becomes more challenging. Knowing how each hive is doing can save time and help the bees. You can lightly inspect or skip hives that are doing well. Plus, the hive tracking allows for more informed decisions. You could call it scientific Indian beekeeping. Of course, beekeepers have come up with many ways to track hive progress. For instance, I met one Indian beekeeper who would place a stone on the front of a hive if it were sick or queenless. One US beekeeper mentioned placing bricks on hive roofs, and another beekeeper I talked to mentioned using wax pens to write information on the top. These could all be great progress methods, but I question if they're fully used. For the Indian beekeeper, of his 100 hives, only 2 had a stone, and yet many of the hives were in pretty poor condition. So all of this motivated searching for easy ways for Indian beekeepers, especially the new beekeepers, to track progress of their hives. I started thinking about a dedicated bee journal. I envisioned that beekeepers would just track the most important things, the honey, the brooding queen, and then everything else just as needed. While I wanted to test if giving out bee journals at training programs would lead to improved honey yields and retention, the Indian beekeepers I met were fairly skeptical. For this reason, I wanted to avoid any writing or reading for the beekeepers, and I shifted towards looking at ways to track hive progress directly on the hive. I first made a slider device where you can move sliders to record if the bees were at risk of swarming. I found it was hard to have really good symbols for all the different pests and problems that a hive could have. So I simplified the design to just look at the queen and the bees, and I came up with a few peg and hole designs. After a few iterations, I realized that this kind of design could be built directly into the hive handles. While I can't guarantee it, the beekeeper said they pay about 10 rupees or about 15 cents extra per hive for this design. In all, there are surely simpler designs, and I think ideas like these are worth a try. Even a design based on a mailbox flag, which is a scrap piece of wood and one nail, might be sufficient. I suspect that even tracking just one or two main things for each hive can make inspections faster and better for Indian beekeepers.